Multiple linear regression is linear regression where the number of independent variables is two or more. You may recall that we talked about simple linear regression in a previous video where it only involves one independent variable. A video on simple linear regression is linked in the upper right corner of this screen. Multiple linear regression models share many features of simple linear regression models. In this video, I'm going to discuss multiple linear regression through a comparison with simple linear regression. There are four topics in this video: marginal effect, adjusted R-squared, test of global fit, and multicollinearity. These are the topics that are not relevant for simple linear regression. Let's begin. Let's take a look at the same trucking company example we have analyzed in simple linear regression. This time, I will consider two independent variables or explanatory variables. They are miles and deliveries. Again, time is the dependent variable or response variable in this analysis. That means we try to use both miles and deliveries to predict time through a linear model. Is a linear model appropriate for these variables? I like to point out that all of these three variables are numerical or quantitative variables, as you can see. In another video, I will consider a situation where the independent variables are categorical. I have linked these videos on this screen. The very first thing we need to do is to create a scatter plot for each x and y. I have done that using XLSTAT. The commands in XLSTAT are given at the bottom of this screen. On the left, we are able to see that a linear relationship between miles and time, as we have seen in the simple linear regression. On the right, we see deliveries is also linearly related to time. We can also examine whether the relationship is linear by using software. For example, in XLSTAT, we can click on Visualizing Data tab, followed by Scatter Plots tab. This time, I selected miles and deliveries as our x, and time as our y. As shown on the bottom, the correlation between miles and time is 0.694, and the correlation between deliveries and time is 0.597. These two numbers indicate that linear relationships are positive and moderate. After verifying the linear relationship is indeed appropriate for each x and y, we can proceed to use software to carry out the linear regression model. The steps in XLSTAT for the multiple linear regression are identical to that for simple linear regression. Just to be sure that you select all independent variables as your x. If you have any questions, please refer to my linear regression using XLSTAT video posted on YouTube that is also linked on this screen. Again, there are three tables generated using XLSTAT: the coefficient table, the NOVA table, and also the goodness of fit table. We're going to talk about each of them in more detail later in this video. From the coefficient table, we can write out the estimated linear regression equation. Estimated time equals to 0.127 plus 0.067 multiplied by miles plus 0.69 multiplied by number of deliveries. We are more interested in the slope coefficients as they represent the effect of each x on y. So the first concept that differentiates multiple linear regression from simple linear regression is the marginal effect. The marginal effect is only meaningful when we have multiple independent variables. It measures the individual effect of each x on y while holding other x the same. To measure the marginal effect of miles on time, we will consider two separate scenarios. Note that these two scenarios are toy examples for illustration purpose only. In the first scenario, we first plot miles against time without considering deliveries at all. This is plotted on the left. We see that as miles increases, time increases as well. We like to understand their linear relationship between miles and time was not influenced by the third variable deliveries. To do that, we color code all observations using their deliveries, as seen on the right. Assume that there are three different levels of deliveries, 1, 2, and 3. When we consider only the observations with deliveries equals to 1, those represented by the blue dots, we notice that time increases with miles. If we only consider observations with deliveries equals to 2 or 3, the relationships are pretty much the same. These three lines, as you can see on this graph, are close to each other. This suggests that holding the deliveries variable the same every time, time always increases with miles. And this effect of miles on time is indeed the marginal effect. Next, let's consider the second scenario. In this scenario, when we consider observations with deliveries equals to 1, we notice that the time stays about the same for different levels of miles. The same can be said for observations with deliveries equals to 2 or 3. This scenario indicates that the effect on time is not from miles, but mostly from deliveries. This also means that the marginal effect of miles on time is not significant, different from what we have observed in the first scenario. In multiple linear regression, because there are multiple independent variables now, we try to isolate the marginal effects from one variable every time. These marginal effects measure the true effects from one variable alone and are not affected by the effects from other variables. Let's see how we can interpret the slope coefficients in the estimated regression model. They are actually measure the marginal effects of the x. For example, 0.067 means for every 1 unit increase in miles, while holding the deliveries the same, the estimated time is expected to go up by 0.067 hours, about 4 minutes on average. And for every 1 unit increase in deliveries, when we hold miles the same, the estimated time is expected to go up by 0.069 hours, that's about 41 minutes on average. There are several questions we can be asked that are related to the estimated equation. Question 1. If miles is 100, deliveries is 3, what's the estimated time? All we need to do is plug all those numbers into the estimated equation and to calculate the estimated time to be 8.897 hours on average. That's about 3 hours and 54 minutes. Question 2. If miles is held constant and deliveries increases from 3 to 4, what's the change in estimated time? In this question, we fix miles and only increase deliveries from 3 to 4. That's actually 1 unit increase. So the estimated change in time should be 0.69 hours on average. Question 3. If deliveries is held constant and miles drop from 100 to 80, what's the change to estimated time? This time, we fix deliveries and change miles. Miles decreases from 100 miles to 80 miles. That's 20 units decrease. So 20 units decrease in miles would lead to 0.067 multiplied by 20 equals to 1.34 hours decrease in time on average. I keep on using the phrase on average because this effect on time is only an estimated effect using a linear regression model. We try to fit a bunch of points using one straight line. Not all points will lie perfectly on this line. Some of them will be above this estimated line, and some will be under this line. But on average, they should be around this line. Question 4 asks whether the effects of both independent variables, that means miles and deliveries, are significant on y, on time. We examined the marginal effects of miles and deliveries individually. We have talked about how we can carry out a complete hypothesis test to test the effect of X on Y in a simple linear regression video. For a quick review, please click on the video linked here. I'm not going to go over the H0 and HA here. The test statistic and p-values of this test are all given in the coefficient table. For example, for miles, the test statistic for testing its slope to be whether different from 0 or not is 27.366, and the p-value is very small. Small p-values imply we reject the null and conclude the marginal effect of miles on time is different from 0, or the effect is significant. Similarly, because the p-value for deliveries is also very small, we know that the marginal effect of deliveries on time is also different from 0, or the marginal effect of deliveries on time is significant. Question 5. What's the 95% confidence interval for the effect of deliveries on time? This question asks us to estimate the effect. We can use confidence interval to do that. Confidence interval equals to a point estimate plus minus a product of a multiplier and a standard error. I'm going to link the video where we talked about confidence interval in the upper right corner. Feel free to refer to that video. The point estimate here for regression is just a slope estimate, which can be found in the table that's 0.069. And the standard error is usually given to us in the table as well. For deliveries, that's 0.03. And it is a t-statistic, so the multiplier is actually a t-multiplier. Whenever we are dealing with a t-multiplier t-distribution, we have to calculate the degrees of freedom. That is n minus k minus 1. Sample size is 300. K is the number of independent variables used in our model. We are considering both miles and deliveries in this multiple linear regression. So k is 2 minus 1. That's 297. We can find a t-multiplier using Excel function t.in function. And even though we're considering 95% confidence interval, the first argument for t.in, we should use 0.975. Please feel free to refer to the video on confidence interval estimation on why we used 0.975 instead of 0.95 to find this t-multiplier. This t-multiplier is plugged in here. Plugging all the numbers into this formula, we were able to find the 95% confidence interval of the effect of deliveries on time is between 38 minutes and 45 minutes. That means we are 95% confident for every 1 unit increase in deliveries. The time is going to increase anywhere between 38 minutes to 45 minutes.